In this example of analysis of variance, I have three populations. And these are some of the values of these populations. I have their means and standard deviations. Then mathematically, I selected three random samples from these three populations, and these are the random samples. My first step in analysis of variance is to find the mean of all data from these three random samples, average, and then I can put the first and the last cell, but I want to show you that we kind of use the whole data block, and this is the grand mean. Now I have the grand mean. My second step is to find the sum of square deviations between the means and the grand mean. I have to multiply each square deviations with the size of the sample. So let's do this. The first size is 10 times something square, plus the second size is 18 times something to the power of 2, plus the third size of the third sample is 23 times something to the power of 2. Within the parentheses, I have the first mean minus the grand mean, second parentheses, the second mean minus the grand mean, and third parentheses, the third mean minus the grand mean. Enter. And this is the sum of square deviations between the means of the three samples. Our next step, after we have the sum of square deviations between, is to calculate the sum of square deviations within the sample. And this is done by calculating the deviations from the mean for each one of the values. So I have the first value minus the mean, and the mean should be with dollar sign because we want one and the same mean. Then I will copy this formula, and the sum of square deviations is a simple formula, sum of all square deviations. Already did the sum of squared deviations for the second and the third sample, and they are recorded in this table. The last step, after I have all sum of squares for the three of the samples, is to find the sum of the sums of all these squares. And this is the value sum of squares within. Now we have all results, and I recorded them in here. Sum of square between, sum of squares within. I have degree of freedom between the samples. Three samples minus one degree of freedom, two. I have degree of freedom within the sample. 51 individuals minus three, the number of samples is 48. So I have the degree of freedom, I have the sum of squares between and within, and I'm ready to calculate the F ratio, or our statistics. It is sum of squares between divided by degree of freedom between. This is the numerator, and the denominator is sum of square within divided by the degree of freedom within, 2.1746. F critical value, which will tell us whether we will fail to reject the null or will reject the null, is equal F inverse 0.05, this is the level of significance alpha, degree of freedom 2 between and 48 within, 3.19, I already recorded here at level of significance alpha for this 2 degree of freedom. We will fail to reject the null hypothesis, unfortunately.